Like people, stars can teach us a lot, but through a telescope, old galaxies look young and old stars have iron deficiency. Whoa. Hey everyone, Trace here for DNews with our weekly space update. This week was a fun week for space, especially for astronomy, because they discovered the youngest galaxy in the universe and the oldest star in the universe in the same week. That's crazy. 13.75 billion years ago, the Big Bang happened. Then a few million years later, the first stars formed. Just this week, astronomers at the Australian National University identified one of those first stars, and it's only 6,000 light years away from Earth. That's real close. These scientists were able to discern the, quote, fingerprint of an ancient star. Basically, new stars have way more iron than ancient stars. For instance, to make a star like our sun, you need a mass of 1,000 Earths of iron. Plus a lot of hydrogen and helium. Easy. But ancient stars have no detectable level of iron, and this one is very rich in carbon. The theory is this is a second generation star that formed in the wake of a primordial one, which are 60 times the mass of our sun, by the way. A primordial star had lots of hydrogen and helium, just like today, but when it collapsed, the ensuing black hole sucked in the iron, leaving this characteristic fingerprint. Hopefully, this discovery will help astronomers learn about how stars formed in the early universe and give us a glimpse into the birth of everything that we know everywhere. The youngest galaxy can also teach us about the early universe because it's not actually young now. The Hubble Space Telescope just spotted the youngest galaxy ever discovered, Abel 2744_Y1. It's so far away, it took 13 billion years for its light to finally reach us. Remember, the Big Bang, 13.75 billion years ago. So the light getting to us now was generated by this galaxy only 650 million years after the Big Bang. It took so long for us to see it, we're literally looking back in time to see how it was, not how it is. We're hoping this will help us learn how early galaxies formed in the first billion years of the universe's existence. Scientists publishing their findings in Astronomy and Astrophysics Letters are also hoping they can use Abel to explore dark matter. Abel 2744_Y1 is 30 times smaller than the Milky Way, but has a massive amount of gravity for some reason. The gravity is so strong, it literally warps the space around it. It creates a kind of a strange lens, sort of like bending glass, which causes nearby objects to look brighter than they really are. Abel 2744_ is also churning out at least 10 times more stars and contains a large amount of gas. They don't really know why. To get as much information as they can, NASA and other astronomers are working together using the infrared from the Spitzer Telescope, X-ray from the Chandra X-ray Observatory, and the Hubble. It's kind of a big deal. Discoveries like this uncover how the universe formed, why it exists, and why it looks like it does now. Do you like astronomy? Do you know much about it? Ask questions at our tweet name, @DNews, or post them down below in the comments. We totally read those things. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews every day of the week, and we'll see you next time.